grab some Doritos, definitely check under the bed, and absolutely stay away from the apple juice. Let's talk about 1989's Little Monsters. What is going on, guys? Welcome back to Movie Watch. My name is Justin, and today we will be talking about 1989's Little Monsters. This is one of my absolute all-time favorite movies ever. I love this movie so much. When I heard Vestron was releasing it on Blu-ray, I was just over the moon. I was so excited. Basically, if you haven't seen Little Monsters, it tells the tale of a family of four, two brothers and their parents move into a new neighborhood, and the parents are not exactly doing well in their marriage. The kids can hear them in their bedrooms as they argue at night, and the kids are really having trouble adjusting to their new surroundings. But what starts happening is little things start happening around the house, things missing, things getting moved around. It looks like there's been some mischief happening overnight, such as, you know, Fred Savage's character's Brian's bike has been left in the driveway, and his dad hits it and gets all pissed off. And of course, the kids are getting blamed for every little piece of mischief that happens overnight. And the kids are convinced, obviously they know they didn't do it, but they can't prove that they didn't do these things. Eventually, Fred Savage's character, Brian, sets a trap to discover a monster underneath his bed, as well as like a massive like underworld of monsters. As a collector, there's certain releases of movies that you get excited about. And this is one that when I saw it was announced, first of all, we hadn't had a Vestron release in a super long time. And also when it was announced that Little Monsters was going to be the next title, I was so excited. Of course, anytime any favorite title of ours gets released on Blu-ray, it's awesome. But every once in a while, there's a title that you just grew up absolutely being obsessed with, and Little Monsters was one of those films for me. It's a great coming-of-age story with Brian and his little brother, but it's also, I remember it just being one of those great gateway horror movies. Little Monsters kind of falls in the same category as movies like The Gate or The Witches, or like Lady in White or Neverending Story, these like quasi-fantasy kids horror films. They don't scare you too much as a kid, and you can kind of just be excited to see that type of stuff on film for the first time. Of course, the movie starts Fred Savage in a fantastic kid performance. He really was one of those child actors that just gave phenomenal performances. He was, of course, great in The Wonder Years, and around the same time, he put out the Nintendo-centric movie, The Wizard, which he was also really good in. But you can't talk about Little Monsters without talking about Howie Mandel. Howie Mandel's performance in this movie is absolutely legendary. It is fearless, it's phenomenal. He gave this role everything he had, and he really just blew everybody out of the water with this role. It was absolutely a perfect role for him. Maurice's character in Little Monsters has often been compared to Beetlejuice, of course, and they are kind of similar with the manic energy and the weird ghost elements, or like monster style elements of the characters, but they couldn't be different as far as like personality and just charismatic wise. But Howie Mandel, most people know him now just of course as being the bald talk show host and Who Wants to Be a Millionaire and all that stuff. But in the late 80s and early 90s, Howie Mandel was one of the biggest stars on the planet. He was a stand-up comedian, and that parlayed into movies. He had a cartoon called Bobby's World in the 80s. He rose to fame, of course, doing stand-up comedy and putting the rubber glove on his head, because he's always been super OCD and stuff, but he always had a glove in his pocket, and he used to put a rubber glove on his head over his nose and blow the glove up until it popped, and that was one of his big shticks. And he just gives the performance of a lifetime. I think he'll always kind of be synonymous with Little Monsters. That brings us to the effects in this movie. The special effects and the makeup effects in this movie still hold up and are just absolutely incredible. Of course, the makeup effects on Howie Mandel's Maurice character are just iconic, with his little dangly horn and his hair. It's just, they're beautiful special effects, and all the different creatures and monsters in the underworld. The sets are amazing. Howie Mandel and the commentary, they talk a lot about the actual sets that the movie was shot on. And they were all built for the movie in these warehouses, and they just feel so surreal, especially the way they did the lighting and the exaggerated cartoonish design of the stairways and the hallways, and the sound design is incredible. They really went all out with the creature effects and the set design in this movie. And of course, the underworld is just every kid's dream, with candy and snacks and foods and sodas and video games and running around and being crazy without parents and everything that was just a kid's dream. It's like Neverland underneath. It's like a horror. It's like the horror version of Neverland. And it's just so, it brought me back so much. As you can tell, I'm super excited to be talking about this movie. I just absolutely love everything about Little Monsters. Now, with this release, I will say picture quality. As with the Vestron releases and their remasters, they do retain a good amount of the grain. So if you might want to adjust your settings on your TV if you don't like a lot of that grain. But of course, it's in high def. It looks beautiful. The colors are vibrant. The picture is great. It looks better than it ever has. Of course, the last time I was watching this was an old master. And watching on VHS and stuff, so it looks fantastic. But it does hold a good amount of grain, which I like, but it doesn't look too soft, it doesn't look too grainy, it just looks great. There's not a heavy amount of digital noise or anything like that. It looks fantastic. It looks better than it ever has, but I know there is some complaints about Vestron's transfers, whether it be too grainy or too much DNR, the digital noise reduction. I'm here to tell you, this movie looks really natural. Aside from the grain, which some people do like, and I do, it's not overrun with digital noise correction or digital color correction. It just looks fantastic. If I had to give it a score out of 5, definitely 3.5 to 4 out of 5 on picture quality. The audio sounds great. The DTS HD master audio, so it sounds great. It's not Dolby Digital 5.0 surround sound. It's still 2.0, but it sounds great. It looks and sounds better than this. Little Monsters looks and sounds better than it ever has, and this is definitely going to be the definitive release of this movie. And we do have quite a few new special features. Going over this new special features, we have new audio comedy with Jared Gahan, editor-in-chief of cultofmonster.com. I know it was a little disappointing to see that we didn't have a director's commentary or Fred Savage or Ben Savage or Howie Mandel commentary. But I'll tell you what, after listening to this commentary, you really get a ton of background information. This guy, I had never heard of this guy, he's Australian. He's head of the Monster Fest in Australia, which is a huge convention. He is the head of that Monster Fest in Australia. And the knowledge that he rapid-fired throughout this commentary was awesome. He did a phenomenal job with the commentary. And oftentimes when you do have a director or actors, they kind of get off topic and they'll start talking about one thing as other things are happening on screen. So oftentimes the director can pick apart his movies during the commentaries, and you don't really get the deep dive, like inside baseball, that you want on commentaries. And I'll tell you what, with this one, this guy really knocked it out of the park with all kinds of really cool behind the scenes facts about the actors, the production, the direction. He even talks about the opening title sequences and the makeup effect. Like, he did a fantastic job. The commentary is well worth listening to. We have isolated scores for specific scenes, interview with composer David Newman, Call Him Maurice, an interview with actor Howie Mandel, which was a great interview with Howie Mandel. Just like with some of these special features, just watching a talking head of these actors, sometimes it's not all that interesting. Howie Mandel really gave a lot of really cool, fun inside facts about the movie. He even still has his leather jacket. He brought the leather jacket that Maurice wore in the movie. He puts it on, he still has it, which was so cool to see him talk about this. And he seemed genuinely so happy to be a part of this movie, which was really awesome. Great interview with actor Howie Mandel. Beneath the Bed, an interview with producer Andrew Licht. He talks about how the movie came together, putting the actors together, putting the whole thing together. It's a really interesting interview. Then you have a brand new interview with makeup effects creator Robert Short, where he goes and deep dives into the makeup effects of the movie, which honestly are some of the biggest highlights and the biggest standouts of this movie. So cool to hear him talk about the effects. And then you have vintage interviews with Fred Savage, vintage interviews with Robert Short. You have director Richard Greenberg behind the scenes footage, Baking Maurice, vintage footage of Howie Mandel's makeup transformation, vintage EPK or electronic press kit, VHS promo, theatrical stuff, trailer, and still galleries. I'm a big fan of still galleries. I love still galleries as a special feature in movies. I look through all those features. I think a lot of people skip over those still galleries and the special features, but they can oftentimes have really fun, like behind the scenes photos and stuff that you'd never see otherwise. So really cool still gallery too. This movie just really hits me in a special part of my heart. Just like films like E.T. and Flight of the Navigator, Neverending Story, Explorers, all those like fantasy coming of age stories that I just grew up watching that just became a huge part of who I am as a movie fan. And I just cannot get enough of Little Monsters in movies like this. These whimsical 80s fantasy movies that bring you back to that feeling of just being a kid and finding your way in the world and coming of age at the hardest time of your life when you don't know what the hell's going on in the world, nobody to show you, you can't relate to your parents, all your friends don't necessarily all have your same point of view because everybody grows up differently, and you really feel at that age just kind of lost and alone. And movies like this really kind of just capture that feeling of needing something to escape to and someone to escape with. And oftentimes, like with E.T. and Flight of the Navigator and Little Monsters, when you have like a boy in a monster type movies and only those two can like understand each other, there's just something really special about those type of movies that I still relate to, and it still takes me back. I cannot say enough good things about Little Monsters. If you are on the fence about picking up this movie, this Vestron video is absolutely a fantastic release, and you will not regret picking this movie up. I highly recommend picking up the Vestron Collector's Edition of Little Monsters. And if you have not seen Little Monsters, this is a perfect way to introduce yourself to the movie. It is just fantastic. Looks great, sounds great. You have new artwork, a new slip cover. They also just released Shivers from Vestron. And this was the 18th or 19th or 19th and 20th. These two releases that they just released. So definitely support the Vestron video line, as it's been a long time since they had released anything. They really want these movies to do well, so I suggest supporting them so we can get more great Vestron titles. But that's all I got today. Thank you guys so much for stopping by. Stay weird. Until next time, bye.
I love movies. Gosh, I love movies. I love watching them. And I love making them.
Nah, I can't. Greenberg had been in a fuck.